Hi everyone, Duke here. Welcome back to the internet's one and only Let's Play Popful Mail program. In the last episode, we had told the town guards that Slick was in trouble, and we talked to this blue-haired freak, see if he has anything else to say. Yeah, you do that. Alright. I meant to do that. It looks like you take damage from falling, but you don't really, which is good. Because that would be annoying to have something as ubiquitous as falling a great distance in this game be something that kills you. Oh, here's another guard. He says a bunch of stuff if you keep talking to him. I'm sort of on the fence as to whether I should be reading the dialogue for the other town's members out loud, like I did sometimes with other games. I mean, there's kind of a lot of it. None of it is really important. Although the important dialogue has professional voice acting by Hollywood's finest. I think Ben Affleck actually does the voice of Slick. I mean, it's not credited as Ben Affleck because, you know, he didn't want it tarnishing his movie career, but I'm pretty sure it's him. This is where those... All that's in that treasure chest is like a friggin' banana or something. I'm not going to stress out too much about it. These freaking clockwork guys who shit rocks on you. Haven't run into any really bad enemies so far. I mean, the most damage we've taken is like 12 to 15 or something. The game really starts getting brutal later on, though. I mean, it is seriously bad. It's going to be a special treat in this episode. I think I'll get to the first boss. He looks tough, but most of the bosses in this game are fairly easy, as long as you know which character to use. Oh, spoiler alert. Later on, you get more characters you can play. I'm not going to tell you who they are, though, because we haven't met them yet. But yeah, most boss battles depend on which character you use and where you stand. If you stand in the right place and you use the right character, then you're in good shape. This room is completely useless. I don't know. There might be a secret here that I'm not aware of. It's very possible because I'm not really a Popful Mail expert or anything. I just happen to enjoy the game. I think I mentioned that I beat it once, and I beat it right before I started playing this game, actually, or right before I started LPing it. Oh, wait, we have another cutscene coming up. Be back with you in a second.
Hello there! Say, I watched you slash your way up here. Most impressive, I must admit. Who are you?
I'm Mail, Popful Mail. Right now I'm after a dangerous magician called Muttonhead. There's a big reward for him.
Oh? Muttonhead used to be my teacher. He was once a kind and wonderful person. But then, all of a sudden, he turned evil. I'm looking for him to see if I can't find out what went wrong. Actually, I should say I was going after him, but the monster just ahead stopped me dead in my tracks. He's much too powerful for my simple scepter.
Don't worry. I'm sure I can take him. I've had a lot of practice lately. This shouldn't take long.
Okay. Well, be careful. Let me know when it's all clear, okay?
Yeah, that guy? Leonardo DiCaprio. Swear to God. Once again, he's not listed in the credits, but that's him. This is the role that landed him the lead in Titanic. Uh-oh. The evil mad bomber, what bombs madly, has appeared. Okay, basically, you want to kill this guy, and you don't want to die. You want to hide under this thing, and just run out and hit him when he stands next to you. It's not flashy or exciting, but... Oops, I missed. This is the one way to guarantee that you can kill him without dying. If you try to do anything else, you're probably going to get a bomb shoved very far up an orifice. I won't say which one. I'll leave that much to your imagination. So yeah, like I was saying, I beat this game shortly before I started LPing it. I acquired it completely legally, and I didn't hear much about it before I started playing, and I was thoroughly impressed by it. Game has a lot going for it. One of the neat things about this game is that the dialogue actually changes depending on various choices that you make, or what character you are when you talk to a certain person. Oh, the blockage crumbled. For example, if we keep going, then the blue-haired guy who we just talked to meets up with us. Oh, he's about to say something. BRB.
Wow! You destroyed the Mad Bomber! Now I can get on with the search for my master.
Didn't I say he'd be a piece of cake? I don't kid around when it comes to a fight.
Well, as I said, your skills are quite impressive. By the way, I'm Tat, apprentice magician extraordinaire. Hopefully, we'll meet again soon.
I guarantee we will. I don't know why she started walking left. Oops. It was some sort of emulator glitch. Don't worry, I'm back in the pilot seat now. But yeah, if you just kept going instead of going back, and then Tat meets up with you later and he's like, "Hey, I thought you said you were going to come get me. Mine. I'm as whiny as Slick." All the male characters in this game are really whiny. And we make our way to Tree Sun, named for its abundant trees and its position under the sun. Whoa! That guy just did 20 to us. His legs are harmless, so don't worry about that once you kill him. Those spiky wheels down there will hurt you if you land on them, so be careful of that. But yeah, this game has really impressive graphics for a Genesis game. Or a Sega CD game, but really it's the same thing. Sega CD doesn't represent a change in hardware, just a change in format, really. And the music is awesome. I kind of wish you guys could hear it better. But no, you have to put up with me yakking over it all the time. It just never ends. Yak, yak, yak. So I'm down to 60 health already because I haven't been watching my step enough. And I'm probably going to die on a regular enemy because I'm just so foolhardy. Let's go ahead and save. I'm probably going to be saving a lot, because in this game it's almost necessary. I feel a little cheap doing it, kind of like abusing save states in another LP. But I guess it's not as bad as save states, because when you load your game, you start out at the beginning of the room that you're currently in, so it's not a total cheat. Total. I should have just blocked that. Most things that shoot projectiles like that, you can block just by ducking. But you can't attack while you're doing it because it puts your shield away. Even though I don't have a shield equipped. There are two shields. There's the shield that you hold out in front to block projectiles. And there's the shield that exists as a theoretical concept. The quantum shield, if you will. Okay, I'm about to die. So I had better eat something. I have available cherry and two apples. Apples don't heal very much. I think they heal the least. Or maybe cherries do. I don't know. I think there's another cutscene. Yep.
Can you get it?
sorry. Can't get involved unless there's something in it for me.
What? Oh, okay. Listen, help me out of here. I'll make it worth your while.
Okay, now you're talking my language. How much?
Let me think. How about 200 gold?
200 gold? Yeah. I guess you don't want to be rescued too badly. I might consider it for, say, 700 gold or so.
700 gold? Man, I don't have that much. But if you'll consider 500 gold, we have a deal.
Fair enough. Consider yourself a free man.
And that'll do it for this episode. See you guys next time on Let's Play Popful Mail. I'm Duke of the Bond. Good night.